Dang, I think we're live. Yeah, we're live. I'm sitting here with Jason Brown of Love Food Truck Company, and we're still testing out some of this new fancy finangled software, and wanted to test it with trying to do some screen sharing, split screen, you know, just getting all our nerd all up and running. And I got three images right now of Jason on my screen. And they're all live. They're all
that's our fan in itself.
It's pretty cool. Twisted Birch, good afternoon, gentlemen. Good afternoon to you, Twisted Birch. So let's see here. John Russell, good afternoon. And we'll go ahead and start this, and y'all just bear with me because I'm going to try to make this show my screen, and hopefully it does. And I'm on the wrong screen, so I'm going to go to this screen, and now I'm going to check it and see if it's showing you what it's supposed to be showing you. I think it is. And I think I can blow this up. Yes, I can. And I can even move it over. And I'm going to try to keep it here for you so you can we can go through these. So, here's the deal. Let me go back to this Facebook thing. So, Jason, what we got first is Stacy wrote into the... What we're looking at, y'all, if you don't know about it, it's the Hot Dog Carts for Sale page. There's a lot of discussions going there. Mostly it's new vendors, people looking for carts and looking to sell carts. And then we have some of the VU members that help out and come in there and answer questions for people. And then I have two people that I hire to help answer questions in there. So we try to answer everybody's question, but sometimes we miss some. Some days there's lots and lots of posts, and some days there's not so many. So let me show you what, Stacy says. Stacy says, do I have that too big? No, it's good. Okay. Stacy says, my first day is done. I did a farmer's market. I didn't have a good space and they were having a food truck night. So there were more food vendors than there will be going forward. 4 hours total, did 190. Dogs are 475. Italians, 575. I had a hot dog cart years ago and about 20% of my sales were Italians. Last night, I only sold three. I'm going to change the menu, took off Italians and raised the meal price to 25 cents. I'm old, my body hurts from standing. My cart is heavy, 550 pounds, and I can't pick it up. I still can't figure out an easy way to get it on my hitch. My old cart had a drop-down leg and has a wheel on it that was great and easy, but I'm unable to do that. This one of the trailers, I don't know what it's called, part that goes on my hitch is 8.5 inches off the ground, and those don't work with it. Does that make sense? LOL. So two things here, and we'll try to cover them both, Stacy. First, congratulations for taking it on. Two, it is tricky when you're bombarded with other food vendors. We get that a lot. In fact, we got it Monday night, didn't we, Jason?
Yeah.
So here's the deal. 4 hours, $190. Let's assume that your cost to do business is about 30%. Total cost involved in what you sold. Okay, so you're looking at about $60, a little less than $60. You made $130 in 4 hours. Four into $130. According to my hillbilly math, is roughly,
32.50.
So that's better than hillbilly math. I was fixing to have to take off my boots. So anyway, I'm looking at this and I'm going, okay, 32.50 an hour. Stacy, you should be proud of yourself. Yeah, I know you've been a vendor before and you're used to making more and you will get there, but you explained right at the beginning it was food truck night. So it was already overkill with food offerings and you still made $32 an hour. Okay. I think you did fantastic. Now this hitch thing, what I would do is I would change my setup. Wouldn't you, Jason? I'd go get a power hitch. You can buy a power one that works off of a 12-volt marine battery.
Yeah, any of the RV shops will have it. I mean, she's probably about $100-$150 for that because she doesn't need a whole lot of tongue weight.
Harbor Freight and Tractor Supply and Northern Tool will have it as well.
That way you just hit a button, it raises up, you back under it, hit the button, drop it down, boom. No more cranking if you know your body's like mine.
It'll save you a lot of time and effort and protect your body, protect your back. knees. Thanks for the people that did comment to help her out. Eli commented that there's a 2,000-pound capacity drop leg frame.
One thing she didn't put in there, but it's in the picture with her menu, she's doing a quarter-pound dog. For those of you that were kind of like $4.75 a hot dog, holy crap, who priced her out? Jason? Well, yeah. She's selling a quarter-pound dog. So, you know, $4.75 for a quarter-pounder, you know, okay. Just so we clear that up. She has chips at a buck, water at a buck, soda, I'm imagining cans at a buck, all dogs include. Ketchup, mustard, onion, sauerkraut, jalapeno, and relish. Cream cheese, a buck extra.
That's good to point. I'm glad you pointed that out. Jason and I always go back and forth on this. Jason is the person that pushes everybody's prices further and higher. I'm one of these that are like, oh, let me give you a value meal for $3 so that I don't make any money. Okay, we're going to try to answer your questions in the comment section that you're commenting on, and I appreciate your participation in our trial here with the screen sharing program. But I'm going to grab Tyler Hilliard, and I don't know if you can see this, Jason, but Tyler says, hey guys, what do you recommend I do to insulate the plastic cooler? Right now, it's just sheets of loose styrofoam that does nothing. I would definitely change that up. I would use gel packs. They make cooler sides. They make it folds out, and you can wrap your entire cooler inside with these gel packs. And those work great. Those work fantastic. Some people I've heard, okay, I've never tried this, but they use bubble wrap, and it doesn't create any. It creates insulation proper value, but it does not have a cooling value. So if you already have cold stuff going in, it should stay that way longer. Bubble wrap is just a budget-friendly way to go.
At that point, you'd be better off putting the bubble wrap across the top of whatever you got there to cut down. If there's a gap between your stuff and the top of the cooler, the bubble wrap would be better across the top on your way out to serve or something like that, just to try and cut down on that dead space. But yeah, it's not going to offer any cooling properties at all.
Exactly. Let's see here. Robert said, I like the spiral hot dog earlier. Spiral hot dogs are sexy, but they're a pain in the neck to do if you're having to produce a bunch of them. They are sexy, though, and they're really even more sexy on a grill. You can turn an 8-inch dog into a 12-inch one pretty quick with a spiral cutter. But
cool the way the toppings drop between the spirals, too.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, let me go back to this, Jason, and tell me when you've got to go, Jason, so I don't hold you up. I know you got stuff.
I'm good.
All right. Here's a hot dog cart for sale Rich Russell has, $2,800. It's got the big sinks in the front. This is a good value. If y'all want to know where to go to get that, it's learnhotdogs.com/used. If you want to see these, all that is a pretty link. It's a short link to the Facebook page. You have to ask to join, and all that's due is to keep the bots out of it. They have all these advertising bots now that put in, you know, cell phones for sale and stuff like that into for sale sites.
And it looks like Rich is retiring.
Rich is retiring?
That's what it says. Retiring, looking for a new owner to give this car a home. Comes with many accessories to help you get started. Located in Milan, Michigan, just south of Ann Arbor, Michigan. If interested, PM me for a list of included accessories.
It's a pretty cart. Yeah. It's pretty. He even lists all below it in the comments. He lists everything that comes with it. Here's Adam Morris. He's a new member. From Clarksville, Tennessee. I've been there a lot of times. Cart with umbrella, pan steam table, ready to make money, located in Clarksville. Nice looking cart. It has the 3-bay sink on the side, hand wash sink on the back. Great cart. That was how much? $2,800.
Yeah.
Not bad. And by the way, you can list your carts for free and you can buy carts for free on there. There's no fees. We do this just as a service of LearnHotDogs.com and Vendors United. Getting ready to start something, wondering how many of you grill split and grill or just steam your dogs.
Well, you know me, I mean, our hot dogs, we steam them. Sausages, we grill them and then hold them under steam.
Right.
I know Ben's one to
boil.
You know, dirty water process. So, We've had many discussions over that. I said flavor doesn't come in, it goes out. That's why the water's dirty.
I get you. I just we've had this battle going forever. And
I ranked up there with the guys that say if you smoke the pork butts fat side up, the fat goes down through the meat and tenderizes. It's molecularly impossible.
Here you go, bringing all the science to us, Jason. All right, so let's see here. Let me go through. Tyler, let me remind you, if you go to learnhotdogs.com/resources, I think we have a link to some of those ice packs, gel packs, that are cool to line a cooler in, that are food safe. Okay. Oh, here's a good one, Jason. I'm going to scroll. Let me pull this one in from our comments, from our live comments.
Okay.
And I'll read this to you. Had a promoter say that the only drink vendor I wasn't stuck. Hold on. Okay. That I was the only drink vendor, and I wasn't. Now stuck with 5 gallons of simple syrup. How long will it keep made Friday?
Well, the best way to keep that would be to put some citric acid in it and, you know, keep it in the fridge.
Tell them what citric acid is, Jason.
It just helps prohibit the growth. It'll give the simple syrup a little bit of twang, if you will.
Yeah, but tell them what it is so they know that you don't go to auto parts store to buy citric acid.
No. You got to get that through one of the food distributors, Southern Snow, something like that. Your broad line would have it. The biggest thing is when you're making your simple syrup from the start, everything has to be sanitized. I use the same stuff when I'm making that as I do when I'm cleaning my beer equipment to sterilize everything. Anything that's going to touch it gets sterilized. Even the sink where I'm drawing water from gets sterilized before we use it. That is the biggest way to keep that stuff fresh longer. Adding a little bit of citric acid to it, to 5 gallons, you probably need about 1.5 to 2 ounces. Give it a stir and then pop it in the fridge, and that should keep for over 2 weeks. I mean, you know, it also depends on the hygiene when you were making it. You know, I don't know if the container was clean, was it sanitized, things like that.
Right.
But it should last for a little while. But how did you go from being the only drink provider to multiples?
Well, we know how, Jason.
They lie.
We were on Vendors United Monday night, and one of the vendors was talking about their experience with a vend where they showed up. They were supposed to be the only one there, and there ended up being 20 something there. And I told them, here's how you tell if they're being honest or not. There's two ways to do it. First, you look at their mouth area, and if it's moving, then they're lying. The second thing to know is if you believe them and you really want to go, ask them to put it in writing. Ask them to put it in writing, or you put it in writing and make them sign it. Because if they weren't willing to sign it, saying that you are the only vendor or the only hot dog vendor or the only lemonade vendor or whatever it is, then they're lying. They're just lying. And most of them lie because they have nothing to lose. The more vendors, the better their little thing goes, and the worse it goes for all of us.
Yep. Better it sounds on Facebook and advertising. And worse is if they're charging you to be there, the more money they make, so they don't care what you make.
Let me pull another question, Jason. Artie Rodriguez says, life gave us lemons and catering. I have well water that is very harsh. How should I go about getting water to vend lemonades? RO system, or is there a water vendor? Reverse osmosis is what it is.
No, I would get it through a water vendor then and get it in the 5 gallon jugs. Do it that way.
5 gallon jugs are easy enough to pick up. You're looking at 35 pounds of water and plus the jug weight, which is typically, you know, minimal. And put them up on tables. You can even they make water jug racks you could even use. That are at an angle that you could have three, you know, a stack of three or a stack of two. You could build one out of plywood. You could just put it on a picnic table. You know, you could set it up however you want and do that. I always did the 5 gallon water jugs, the potable water. You can buy those potable water jugs if you can fill it up at a city tap. I don't care for city tap water because of the chlorine in it. Will change the flavor, which means you have to add more lemon, more sugar to combat the chlorine. So if you can get really good water that's already been RO'd, you're good to go.
Yeah.
All right. Let me make sure there's not any more. We should be coming to Tennessee within the next 2 weeks to pick up our cart. Ben, would it be possible to come to your shop someday and check it out, some of the carts, and get a feel for what I want or need? Yes and no. Your best bet is to go to, you can do it. We have people come every single day, but it's by appointment, and you go to Learn Hot Dogs. No, go to our website at Ben's Carts. At the top of the page, click questions, and in the questions, one of the first ones, I think, is, can I come to your shop? And it has an appointment number you call. It's not through me.
Do I need a passport to come to your shop?
No. We do that right in America.
Okay, just check.
But I will tell you, let's talk about that for a second. A little bit of a rant. I don't know if you're aware of it, but I know you are, Jason, that we don't make wheel bearings anymore in America. And this isn't a rant about, hey, let's, you know, we got to make it here. No. You know, if I see a Chinese person in the ditch, I don't go, oh, crap, they're Chinese, I'm not going to help them. So we should look at it as a one world thing, but I know we don't. We go, first, we need to take care of America, and I agree. Take care of yourself first, then you're able to help other people. But without getting into the humanitarian side of this or the humanity of it all, most of our steel products come out of China and the Philippines, and then they go through Canada or Mexico to get to us. Okay? Most of them. Steel foundries have gone away. I know that President Trump has said he's putting these basically tariffs on Mexico, Canada, which slows down the Canadian imports of steel and the Mexican imports of steel, which all came out of China and the Philippines, either way. And we're the ones selling them our raw steel. So either way, the tariffs happen. Guess who pays, though? You and I. Because we have to buy from them, okay? We have no choice but to buy from them. Go try to buy some wheel bearings for a commercial vehicle today in America and see how that works out for you. So most manufacturers are having things shipped in. So even Ford and Chevy and Made in America, you know, companies, most of the parts are coming out. If it's steel, it's coming out of China, ultimately, okay? And it doesn't mean you're getting less quality, because they get to determine the quality of the steel, how much alloy goes into it, you know, what is the combination of alloys. So if you look at most hot dog carts, most anything, vehicle with a wheel and axle, that wheel and axle came out of China. Guaranteed. Came out of China. If they say different, they're lying, is the bottom line. Doesn't mean the cart wasn't made in America or anything else. Our carts, and I've said this before, I've had people come in our shop, I've showed them the decal, our axle hubs and everything come out of China. You can't get them anywhere else. Okay, you can get them from Canada, but they came from China. So,
China anyway.
Right. And, you know, they just interviewed one of the largest steel foundries left in America, and they asked him, will this new embargo, this new thing that Trump put on, how many jobs will it create? 44 jobs, he said. 44 jobs. But the prices of steel just went up 31%. But we did get those 44 new jobs. So we're good there. I don't see the logic in it. I think there's a way to do that safely and fairly. But bottom line is, you can't avoid it. Most of you are carrying around a cell phone. How you like it? I like mine. I like my cell phone, and it works pretty good. And mine was made in China or Korea or somewhere else in Asia, Eurasia. Anyway, that's my little rant. Jason, do you have anything to add there?
Well, just, you know, people running their mouths about nothing they know. I mean, you know, I want to support America too, but when we started making the chill trays, I searched high and low for, what, 8 months trying to find somebody in the U.S. to build me frames. couldn't get it done. Had to bring it in from China, but put together here, nothing you can do. Good quality and stuff, but...
Oh, you can get whatever quality you want out of the country, but you can't... There's certain things you can't get. If you go to a steel manufacturer here, he's getting his steel from China. Ultimately, it's coming from China. No way around it. So... We're not making steel anymore.
I just laugh at some of these morons talking about stuff. They have no idea what they're talking about. You know, but that's me.
Yeah. Okay. We should be coming, let's see. We should be coming to Tennessee within the next 2 weeks to pick up our cart that Daniel Jackson says. I'm going to pull that over real quick. Daniel, that's awesome. Congratulations. Hopefully I'm there when you come. That cart is from Doc Dogs in Michigan. Doc Dogs in Michigan is the cart that we pointed out a minute ago. Dave Rhodes, driving. No. Love having this going through Bluetooth throughout the... he's got it through Bluetooth broadcasting. Dave Rhodes does. He's broadcasting this through his Bluetooth, through his car speakers. Eric Von Dumm says to get a water purifier. Basically, you could get a water purifier. It'd take you longer to do gallons and gallons. It depends on how much lemonade you're doing. If you're going to do 5 gallons of lemonade in a day, yeah, get a purifier. If you're going to be doing 300 gallons of lemonade, then it's better just buy the water. Is a cooler just a plastic? Hold on. Is a cooler just plastic within plastic and a gap of air in the middle? So couldn't you drill a hole and spray expandable foam and increase cooling properties? No, most coolers do have foam in them. Especially your better cooler, Coleman, they all have. But air gaps, dead air gaps, are one of the best insulating properties, so you're all right in that. Let's see. I should mention the cooler is a reach-in in between the steel and the frame, he says. Tyler does. Shouldn't make any difference. You can still line it. Unless I've misunderstood your question. Artie says, okay, Artie, this is Jason, I'm giving you this. Eric's, he's talking to somebody else, sorry. Hey, man, what is the best way to remove stickers from a cart? I recently bought a used Big Dog. Also, what is the best way to shine the cart? All right, Jason.
Heat gun and gooby gun.
Did y'all get him? Heat gun.
Yep, heat gun to warm them up. Peel it off with a plastic scraper. Do not use metal. Peel it off. The residual, you know, residue will come off with gooby gone. Best stuff to use. And then polishing it, I use wadding or, I'm trying to think what the name is. It comes at Walmart in a tin where you got to pop the lid off. It's called wadding powder. And the can's blue and white. And it kind of looks like dirty cotton. And, boy, you smear that on there on whatever you need to clean and then hit it with a nice microfiber towel and it buffs right out. You know, something I've been thinking about trying on some of my stainless and stuff, I just had the wife's car ceramically coated, that nanotechnology.
I've seen it. I've seen a video on Facebook, of all places, but I didn't know where to get it yet. I didn't even know it was out yet.
Yeah, I just had it done on her new little rally car thing, and it's amazing. I put some pictures on my Facebook page if you want to see it. But
all right.
I'm thinking about trying that on some of the food truck surfaces. And, I mean, this stuff lasts 3 years, no need to wax it. He took a cup of muddy water, dumped it on the hood, and it just hit and bounced off, and there was not even any moisture on the hood, let alone dirt. So he also did the rims. Now the rims get all the brake dust on the spokes of your tire for the car.
Right.
He took rims off the car and treated the rims, too. So I'm thinking about talking to him to see whether we can do a little test of the food truck on some of the surfaces outside to keep it cleaner. Also, scratch resistant. He took a handlebar to his wife's car in the garage and took a microfiber and wiped it off. He took a... it was a plastic bottle, and you had the top, you press down, and the lid pops up like that.
Yeah.
He had it closed, showed me it, took it on the car on his wife's hood and, like, scratched it, I don't know, 20 times like this. And when he showed me the lid, it was rubbed down, like, worn down the plastic.
Right.
Like, he scuffs on his wife's hood, and he took a microfiber towel and went across it, gone.
Holy cow. I didn't know that I didn't know it would protect it against something. I knew dirt and grime. I didn't know it protected against something like abrasive.
Scratch it too, because it's ceramic. It's amazing. So I'll know how that goes. We'll try and test that in another week.
Okay. Out of the box ass. Ben, I have a task because I'm new to this. I'm attending a Second Amendment march and volunteered a percent of the proceeds to the event. Unbeknown. What's your question?
What to give them? I would give them more than 10%.
Yeah, I mean, you can raise your prices and give them more. And me, I always have this rule: give till it hurts.
Yeah.
And you'll come out ahead in life. One, if it just made you sleep better for a night, wouldn't it be worth it? You can't give to the point that it jeopardizes your safety or your safety in protecting your family. But you can give till it hurts.
You can also make your tips donatable too. Say, hey, all tips are going to this too. 10% of sales or whatever percentage you decide on.
Right.
Add your tips into it. Michael Wood from Doug's Dogs down in Georgia, he gives all his tips to Georgia Wounded or Atlanta Wounded Warriors, I think it is. And if you check his website out or his Facebook, he's always cutting checks to those guys from his tips.
Broccoli Heart says, long time no see, Jason.
I've been here. You miss this ugly mug?
Yeah, you got to join Vendors United. You got to get in Vendors United. You see Jason all the time.
You do a screenshot of this, you can put it down in your basement. It keeps rats out.
Okay. Okay, here's a good one. Tristan Sponsel. Also, I have a second big dog with the on-demand water system. It is my third heater in 6 years. Any advice on how to stop these from breaking? First one rotted all inside, was trash. This one now, there was let me put up the rest of her post. There was metal safety feature cracked in half. Garbage, really don't want to buy one every year. Yes, two suggestions. Get it in your head that some things, if they're used or not properly stored, will deteriorate. Okay? Some people have been known to put in antifreeze, thinking that they're going to protect it through the winter, and it will corrode it and eat through some of the plastics. Some people don't use the RV stuff that we preach to use. It doesn't matter if you buy a water heater, an on-demand heater, that is less than $200, you're not getting a $1,200 heater. Even the $1,200 ones will tell you not to use outdoors, even though they say camping heater. And there are some $1,200 ones. They will give you, most of them, a 90-day warranty. We warranty our stuff for a year unless it's a freeze out, like you froze it out, you know, or you and Mother Nature. We guarantee it against manufacturer's defects. But again, I'm not making those. I'm buying those. They make them to our specs, and we've changed those specs over the years. We try to put out a good product that people can afford. I can go all out and have the iPhone of heaters. It'll be about $950, but there are already some people selling those, and you'll find those even on eBay, and you can Google them, and there's some really, really, really good ones, okay? They might get you a year or two.
Wait, you're telling me my iPhone can boil water?
That's it.
I've been using the steam table in the truck all this time. I could have used my iPhone.
Exactly. But, Kristen, I'm not trying to be a smartass. What I'm telling you is there's some things that will wear and tear. It's kind of like saying my tires keep going, you know, I keep wearing out my tires. Any suggestions? Yes, don't drive your food truck anymore. Or buy wooden tires. They'll last longer. Or the steel ones. You know, just steel tires. They make a noise on the pavement, and most states don't let you drive on the road anymore with steel tires unless it's pulled by a horse. But my point is, and I'm being sarcastic and a little facetious, but my point is some of those things you have to expect to replace. You just have to.
The other thing would be, you know, when you're done using it, make sure it's blown out, that there's no water in there, not using antifreeze, it's going to corrode. Things like that will help the longevity of it. It's also how you use it and how you store it, but it also is a business expense. Tires, they wear down.
Right.
Propane, it runs out. You know, and like Ben said, sure, you could spend all that money on a nice expensive one, but it's no better. Control panels still go. Things happen. You're bouncing down the road, you know?
Yeah. It's one of those things I have to look at. Like, I know that I'm going to replace certain things. usually my gray water tank, I replaced them every year on the carts when I was even renting the carts out and had other people running them, because it's a cheap part. You know, it's a $12 part. And even though, yes, I could clean it, but it would take me about an hour to clean it. My time's worth more than 12 bucks, and so I just bought a new tank. Donate that one to Goodwill and be done.
Well, you talk to a vendor like Michael from Doug's Donuts. I think he keeps a spare water heater in his trailer. Just because you never know what happens. Could be a hell of a pothole. Who knows? But, you know, there's things you need to have on hand to replace.
Another vendor filed a complaint with the state against me because I volunteered a percent of sales to the 2nd March, and they said I'm infringing on their sales. Am they can file all the complaints they want, and that's called free enterprise. That's in the federal constitution. Yeah. That's you're protected under the constitution. They're just idiots and assholes, and don't worry about it.
100% away, and there's not a damn thing they can do about it.
Right. Can I add a chest freezer to my hot dog cart to sell ice cream? Richard Stewart asked.
That's got to be an awful small chest freezer. 5 cubic feet at the most.
Yeah.
I mean, there's those ones you had for a while to do the AC/DC, right? How many quart was that?
63 quart.
Yeah, that one did freezer or fridge and ran AC/DC, right?
Right, ran off AC/DC and the solar panels on our chilled trikes.
Yeah.
So, here's my suggestion there. For the weight of it, you have to have the batteries, you have to have the solar panels, you have to have an inverter. I would go with a marine grade, commercial grade cooler with either dry ice. Unless it's some kind of soft serve, don't try dry ice with soft serve. Dry ice with your hard cones, hard popsicles, that stuff, or do the nice, expensive gel packs, freezer packs, the good ones, commercial ones. Line the whole cooler in it. Freeze your cooler too. You can freeze your cooler in a walk-in freezer. If you can't, don't worry about it. But the colder it can be when you start, the better off you're going to be. Then put in your ice creams and stuff and open it as infrequent as possible. Jason and I both did this for a couple years with bikes.
Yep.
And it's a tricky one. You have loss.
Me, I would say stay away from ice cream on a dog cart. Add something like cold brew coffee, iced tea, lemonade. You know, lemonade would be my first go-to if you're doing an add-on to the cart. You'll make more money off of lemonade than you will ice cream. Novelty ice cream. Less aggravation, too. Hate to piss in your Cheerios, but, you know.
No, it's not even pissing in Cheerios. Most people want to know the facts. And they, yeah. And without sounding negative, Jason and I aren't here to be negative or tell you that, oh, it can't be done. You need to go work at McDonald's. You know.
Well, there's a few of them that should do that.
Right, but that is the prettiest bird I've ever seen in my life. Somebody's like pet exotic bird must have escaped. I don't even know what that is, but that is cool. Anyway, we've been on here long enough. I've hope you enjoyed it. We may come back another time and do some more of these out of the hot dog carts hot dog carts for sale page. If you want to join that page, it's learnhotdogs.com/used, just used, like used carts. And it's free. There's no fees or anything in it. And we have people that are actively working to help answer your questions and help you out through it. I hope you had a great one. Enjoyed it. Love it.
See you guys.
See you later.